because the guys you're killing are controllers and you fought those guys before with just regular weapons, but it's still stupid.
It's inconsistent visually.
Yeah, it is.
You forgot how to do them. God, and you have to get this like perfect shot. That's what I hate about this fucking dumb gun, dude. Classic enemy gauntlet. We forgot to put action in our game. So here it is. Please understand. Remember this guy you only see one time ever?
Yes, I do.
Well, that's good, because here he is again. It's a good game, not an excellent game, but it's worth playing if you get it the right price. What? It's got issues, but it's a good game here. Decent hours out of it, we're about at the end.
Yeah, it's
usually not more than 15, so.
About 30 minutes from being done. If that.
Definitely not a flawless game. But.
Oh no.
It's worth playing. Maybe not for an exuberant price, but.
Looked really good, and I was excited to play it on release. I did, and I went, you know, it's cool and all, but. What the fuck were you thinking sometimes?
Yeah. A lot of inconsistencies. Poor gameplay choices, level science kind of fuck. Bosses, little bloated stories. Hit or miss, but I like concepts. I like how it looks. It feels fine for what they try to do. I think it's worth it enough for sure. Left or right?
Left. Wait.
Damn good.
Oh, okay. This lets you get out. Go farm some tweak, I guess.
Yeah, splim.
I was pretty sure it was left, and that was completely correct. I'm a god.
He's a god. He's probably trying to lead me to the boss. He was wrong.
No, I wasn't.
Mm-hmm. We believe you.
I believe you, too.
I like Axiom Verge levels of fuck. Rage is just totally misleading. Closer to that than it isn't. Nice, dude. Man, I really love the tweak system, dude. These fucking annoying little enemies. Oh, man.
Time to pop.
I love farming, boys. Makes me feel alive. No enemies. Awesome. How does farming in like Metroid feel better than this for some reason? Probably because I don't have any problems with the general gameplay of that. Or the tweak to shits, having a farm farm on top of that, so I doubled the pain. Yeah, dude. He like fucking rises up.
Time to load you in.
Oh my god, dude. Everybody's fucking just getting a piece, man.
I told you to load it and you didn't listen.
Why would I load it? Yeah. I didn't have fucking full tweak in the first
yeah,
place.
Yeah, you did.
I had
you
two.
Saved with full, idiot.
No, I did. I saved with two.
You saved with full, idiot. You just did.
I didn't save there.
You literally just hid in town.
I didn't save there.
Yes, you did.
I'm pretty damn sure I didn't.
I fucking saw you.
I don't think I did. I've been trying to avoid doing extra save.
Okay.
Check the tapes, man.
There's no reason not to save.
Yeah, it's a waste of time.
No. Literally, the save file said settlement 17. Get the fuck out of my face.
It's probably selling 17 at the bottom too, from
no,
I know.
It's not. It's fucking Block Rock.
I don't remember saving there, man.
I'll kick your ass. Not even one more time.
I didn't lie to you. I don't remember saving there. Check the tapes, but I still
fucking
don't believe
goldfish
it.
Goldfish memory lying piece of foot.
I'd like to see you come kick my ass. Under all this shit. Quality time.
Fuck you.
Oh, it's the eyeball. Crap. I wonder if everybody's gonna be a huge dick by the end. Oh, wait. The ending's gonna suck. Never mind.
Yeah,
that'd be awesome if everybody's just like, damn, we suck. Thanks, Robin. That would've been. Even if just that's like really basic, it'd be fine. It's gonna be dumb, though. Who's this asshole supposed to be anyways, man?
Altman.
Icon of prayer.
There's mother statues, but this is the guy that Chrome shot in the stomach when he was in a wheelchair. He was the previous...
Before leader. Mother, that's him.
Alright, boys. Kino's back on the menu. Let's go.
Up, dude. Ta-da. Bizarro. Am I supposed to see him dodge? Oh. Random.
Had a double jump to help you stay here.
Yeah, that's shit, man. I should have put that on.
Oh, dude, nice. You totally deactivated this third one. The choices you make in the game will deactivate these shadows if you make the right choices. I don't know what you did for this one, but you did.
I guess I didn't make enough choice. Can you do all of them even?
I think you can. But I had to go through all three of them. Well, all four, but...
Is the third one supposed to be?
I think it's Royal.
That makes sense. First one was Jackwagon because of the sword.
Yeah.
I am the pretty girl.
That is a great dress. And guess what? You can never unlock a New Game Plus where you get to use that dress. That dress is unusable. Fuck you.
Oh, yeah. You'd have to make all the sprites again, though.
Honestly, you should be rewarded.
No. Later, dude.
See ya, bitch.
I can do everything. I'm the chosen one.
I didn't walk into his arms either, but I assume it just kills you.
Yeah. I could do that whole thing again each time.
Maybe.
Kinda suck. Doesn't have emotional impact the second time. Farther beyond, man. That was looking good, too. I think he stopped once he went back on the inside the first. Oh, good. This isn't shit. What happened to this kind of shit, man?
I don't know, man.
It's like he just had mood swings when he was designing this game.
And he gave you all your health back, too.
Oh, shit. Now it's gonna be even easier.
Phase boss fight, go!
Oh, probably not gonna be just this. Tagging them now. Let's go. Is that a checkpoint right there?
Yeah.
That's what that is. It's a nice little icon for it.
This is about the point where I decided this game.
This is where the game jumped the shark, you could say.
Yes.
quite literally.
I wanted to have a Ridley in my game. How do I put him in? I know. I'll have him pilot God.
So is this like War of the Worlds, but with a fucking crow, dude? The
Don't you
aliens
get it? Her name is
are
Robin.
here.
She's fighting another bird. It's fucking incredible.
So it's like War of the Worlds, where the aliens are there to harvest humans for fuel.
You literally did just have Ridley music.
Take my story seriously. Oh, by the way, it's controlled by a giant crow. The Wizard of Oz, if you will.
The Gizzard of Oz.
The Gizzard of Oz. Dang. What's up, bro? Fuck the sauce.
Take the heat, get out of the fucking kitchen.
What exactly is going on here? It's a visual cluster.
It's great because he has all the abilities you do. He can charge his wrench.
Yeah, they use that one a lot. Too hot? Yeah, it's been hot in my room too, but probably not as hot as where you are. God is a bird. God is a bird piloting a bigger bird. And we've jumped the shark. Many times, actually. We just keep jumping. Just like a row of sharks. Fabio just... Not Fabio, what was his name? The Fawns, dude. The Fawns just keeps jumping on them. Just one seed, and the rest of no one. So is this like sequel bait? And there's like gonna be a race of birds? They went from trying to make some grimdark, weird, ambiguous, mean story to... Hey dude, war against the birds.
Look at this bullshit.
Why would this happen? I get that he was sucking the fuel out of the world, but why is killing him returning the fuel to the world alive? Even in the fucking metal. I do love to shit him. He right.
Look at this. Look at this scene. Look at this.
Prancing deer birds. The year of the deer, man.
Garbage.
Where's the leather?
Look. This is so funny, I'm laughing, I'm not fucking losing my mind.
This is like a Suda scene where he just wanted to have a happy moment, or Suda just wanted to have random... What? Why is he dead?
I don't know. I don't know.
Those aren't even evil people. They're just misguided. Yeah, fuck humans, I love deer. You're the deer baby. Oh my god, is that... Please just roll credit. Like, you just wanted to have a happy scene, man.
I know.
Might as well just make it sequel bait at this point, you know? Like, you just want a happy scene. Just
I
have
can't
it.
Tell if he got cold feet and wanted to make something happy because he was afraid of doing something so bleak. Or
this is
if
why
he
I
always
think,
wanted this.
This is why I think the rest of it was just intentions handled poorly and not actually planned for everybody to huge asshole. I think he wanted to make it seem really emotional. Everybody looked like a huge asshole. To make it seem hard or, you know, tough or something, but it just didn't pan out that great. We need to be more variety of shit going on to have a fucking ending like that.
Especially when you jump the shark and there's like a fucking bird pilot in the god thing. Get fucked, pussy. I do like that, though, that everybody is telling her what the fuck to do, and everybody's being a pussy and giving up. And then she goes and, like, saves the world just cause. And they're like, well, sorry about that. Like, fucking goes to sleep, fucks off. How is Robin a better character than these guys who had actual dialogue? Wow, it's sometimes like less is more in the right spot. It's like a joke thing at the end. You have a super serious thing with all this lore and world building, and then the end is like,
I know.
She just goes to bed, dude. Fuck you, brother. It's like the fucking like some fucking joke story.
You're preaching to the fucking choir right now. I know.
You know what I mean? Like, it's like two totally different tones. Remember when people's arms were getting ripped off? Oh, yes. Caveman DCJ, dude. Caveman DCJ.
Of course.
I would really appreciate if you'd be quiet. That's that guy. Bass, dude. That's a good dude. All these guys, all this like Game of Thrones, like just kill people out of nowhere. Oh my god, we thought they were gonna do so much cool shit and then they just got killed. Whoa, it's crazy.
By the way, Royal's fucking dead. He's just dead on the moon.
Yeah, and you kill all these awesome characters. And then the end is like a fucking, I don't know if it's supposed to be a message about, like, just do what you gotta do, even if everybody says no kind of thing, but it comes off almost as a fucking joke.
Reminder, Elro's family fucking died.
Yeah. I like how it's funny. Like, don't tell me what to do to the point you have to go this hard, and then they're finally like, okay. Okay, at the end of the day, I liked it. I did like the game. I thought the last few bosses we did should have been what the rest of the bosses should have been like. I thought the last boss was good. The two bosses before that were fine, which are side bosses. I thought a couple of the bosses near the end game were okay. I thought a lot of the bosses were just kind of bloated with new mechanics and shit that just didn't really work very well.
Behold, she's gonna kiss.
Visual messes and shit like that.
You're gonna fucking smooch.
Wow, they really did so much at the end of the day, didn't they? Remember when Samba was a huge bitch to her?
Yeah.
Yeah, me too. Better throw a smooch on her. If you act like that to me, I throw you in the fucking dump. What?
The cat, Oedipus.
Hmm. Oh.
Because
should have been Schrodinger. Should have been Schrodinger, dude.
It's a fucking Oedipus complex joke, Katie.
I know, I know, but I'd much prefer just the low, the weak Schrodinger's laughing gruff, huh? Buckle. Yeah, I thought the last boss was fine. There's even some Kino scenes. I don't mind that it's looking into her and her friends causing her grief and shit. I think that's fine. Honestly, I would have been fine with the fucking giant thing piloting the god thing if the rest of the story had that much campiness in it. It just didn't.
Okay, so the thing with that is, do you know what the word iconoclast means?
No.
It means someone who acts against the established order. So the entire thing here is that they're
everybody
trying to go against the
order
because the order is wrong. You know, everyone's doing that. Chrome gets fucked for it because he's a fucking dipshit just trying to put in another order. And that's the point of him.
Yeah.
But the thing is, you're supposed to be overthrowing the order. Like, whether that's religion, whether that's science, whatever it is. So at the very end, he comes in and he says, actually, the order was fake all along. Woohoo, it was all for nothing. Which is okay to do.
I think
he does it by throwing in a fucking alien bird who has been leeching fuel.
I think it's more
the entire
time
for no reason. Yeah. It's just thrown in. There's no reason for
it. I don't think that's exactly what it is. I think that It's better than that. I think they're trying to show that there's a bunch of orders, like, because they talk about the pirates being wrong, and they talk about your brother being wrong, which represents just like some outlier, and then it shows the actual order people being wrong, and she's just saying, like, fuck all of them, which I think is a better message than giving it credit for. It's just like totally individual. Like, she flies in the face with everybody.
No, I'm not insulting the message. I think he just shits the bed at the end.
No, I think he jumped the shark with the bird thing. He tried to like sneak in like a War of the Worlds thing when he totally didn't need to do it.
Not only that, the star. But he ends it with a happy ending. How do you have a game that has all of this in it and all the characters are like completely irredeemable pieces of shit except like Royal, who still gets fucked at the end? Like, how do you have all these characters and all these events that are bad, and then at the end you just go, oh, I think there's trees everywhere. Everyone's
I mean, I think you can have a happy ending. I think it kind of is like, it comes off as a little cheesy.
You can have a happy ending.
I think you can have a happy ending because
this narrative did not ever like build itself up to be leading to a happy ending. It was just things are getting worse
all
the time. I think
they should have made it so that it made Robin like out to be a person who's just kind of like, fuck you more to everybody. You know, like have people ask her to do things and she just goes and does her own thing. I mean, she did that, but not visually ever. You just kind of did it as the player. I think it'd be fine then. Like, do what you gotta do to make like a happy ending kind of thing in the face of like all this crazy sadness and bad shit going on. I think that'd be better. If they just made Robin look like she was trying to do something for her own good because she wanted to do it, not because everybody else wants to do something else, like that would have been fine. But instead, you just Robin is kind of there, and then at the end, she's like, "I'm a free-willed individual."
Like it's just and the entire establishment falling apart, all these establishments falling apart, and everyone's doing their own thing. But they were always assholes in the first place, which is what got him in trouble. So the establishment didn't matter, and that's all fine.
I think
that's good and all.
They should have simplified the story.
Whatever.
I think if you're gonna go for a simple message like that, which is a fine message. You double down on the people telling her to do certain things. You cut out a lot of the fucking crazy ass world building and all these meandering plots and subplots and just make it about the fucking message, man. Focus in on those three characters. Make them seem kind of like almost adversaries, man. And have like Robin actually make more reactions to shit.
Go hard on that message. What he should have done is have everyone just always telling her what to do and going, Robin, you're so great. You're so great. Do this thing for me. Like they did. But then at the end, she fucking fails and dies.
No.
And then everyone gets fucked because they relied on someone else.
They didn't improve themselves.
That was the thing.
That's fine.
These characters,
too.
They never actually had arcs that resolved them. Chrome died being still an asshole. He didn't evolve. Royal did evolve, and then he still got fucked because he had made too many mistakes by that point. Royal was like the best character.
Yeah, Royal had a good arc. I think just randomly killing him off kind of sucked. I mean, I guess that's fine if you're trying to make that kind of tone where shit just sucks, right? But I don't know. I don't think that she needed to like die. I don't have some hard on for having everybody die to make the same message.
You can do.
I like this better.
You can absolutely do that.
I like this better because she had like the bit of sass at the end and shit. And you can't have that dialogue where it's like her brother is like finally like, okay, you can do what you want if like she's dead. And I thought that was a little bit better. Showing like you need to rely on this person to survive, I don't think is as good as somebody telling everybody to fuck off silently. And then just doing what they gotta do. I kind of like that better. They had enough sad shit. Honestly, I mean, this felt like unique. But ending.
You can do a good ending.
I think it was a little
you
cheesy.
Can do one. Just it just was not done well here, and I hate it.
I think it was a little cheesy, but I didn't have that big of a problem with it. I had the bigger problem. I didn't have a problem with her coming back and just going to bed and shit. I had a bigger problem with fucking.
I don't mind the going
the
to
jump
bed
in
thing.
The shark fucking
the trees
thing.
Popping out of the earth everywhere and solving everything magically.
Well, I guess the point of that is so that they can see that. I mean, how else are they going to visualize that? How else are they going to... Yeah, that was... I mean, that's what I mean. Visually, it was cheesy as fuck. That was stupid. How else are they going to show, like, everybody in the world that she did the thing, you know? Like, they're not... You make it, like, super visual, then it's, like, really obvious. And she did, like, a huge thing, even though everybody told her to go to bed or whatever. I think it's fine. I think they just... Yeah, visually, it was cheesy as fuck. And they kind of jumped the shark on the, the Raven pilot in the mech. And I think that was just like a twist for the sheer sake of it. I think tone-wise, you've cut the Raven out, it would have felt more in line. Because you have that whole like dream sequence right before that, and then you just fight the god dude that killed Royal, and then like you could just be done, you know? And then she could just like wake up or go to bed or whatever. But instead they make it like
and
everybody's
they don't
grown
back
for
this,
him.
This like... amazing hacking Chekhov's gun of the fucking mind control. Like, I thought there was going to be some major twist with this shit, and it's like, nope, it's just a side note.
Yeah, I'm just guessing not, because maybe it was just to show that there's still things going on the side,
like,
you know, technology
so
and all that.
Depth, cause... he could have put in so many things in the background that he could have elaborated on, and he didn't ever.
I think should have cut out some of that. Just cut out some of the flack. Kind of, if you're gonna have these big moments with, like, Black and all that shit, give a little backstory. Or just fucking cut the bitch out and just make it a generic fucking asshole. Who's like some fucking devout soul or whatever. And then double down on the people who are fucking trying to, like, steer here everywhere.
They gave her a slight bit of backstory. When you found the converter pod and they showed the cutscene of someone losing their arms, that was her. They gave you something and they gave some elaboration on her, but they didn't do enough.
It wasn't enough to give me three bosses worth of fucking cares, man.
He just had a real problem making a character so you can get attached to.
I think they should have had, if this was the big message, and it seems like a very simple one, I think it's a fine one. They should have definitely doubled down on people steering her around and less on random subplot, the development, and just all these random people and the crazy lore and all that shit. You couldn't tell where it was going
like
until
Chrome
it ended, right?
Chrome is great too, because he is outright like Robin trying to stop this bullshit going on, but he's just trying to place his own bullshit in there instead, and then he gets fucked for it, which is totally fitting and everything.
Here's how it should have ended. Fucking mischief makers, dude. Yeah, dude. Should have picked up that Raven and just fucking like flipped his fucking electric ass. Nice, dude. The Beast Sector. The Beast. What was it? Beast Sector? I don't remember how to fucking say that. That was a good game. Thanks for resubbing, by the way. 17 months in a row, too, man. But yeah, man, I don't know. I think, yeah, I totally think that other than the cheesiness of how visually it's displayed, the ending's fine. I really think the fuck you, I'm gonna do my own thing, could have been hammered in just a little harder. Because they didn't cover her strain from the path, or doing her own thing that much. She didn't have enough character, you know? Is everybody else saying what character she did have? I think from her brother's perspective, her brother was handled good.
Metroid, the character doesn't speak, but they don't because there's never a narrative. They do it in Other M and Fusion.
And you just, you know, Samus is a badass because it's very simple. She kicks fucking ass.
She has a mission. Whereas with this character, you don't have an established mission. So she just goes in and gets bossed around and never actually conveys her own thoughts in pretty much any way.
I think what you do with her brother, I think you could just leave her brother. This person is always flexing his will on her, thinking he knows what's best. You have her react a little more and like sprites, you know, just a little bit. And then have the same thing with Maria, the opposite end of the spectrum, you know? She never really reacts with Maria. They just seem like good friends. But at the end of the day, she's still doing something against what Maria
would
want. Because Maria says to go home all
the
time.
Part where you play as Elro and Mina and just go through all the three of those bosses with Robin. And before that point, before you even get to Elro's forced drama, just like have her push him down on the ground. He keeps trying to get up and she just keeps pushing him down. And that's it. Just fucking end him there. Just get him out of the way and have her convey that to the player that she's getting him out of the way. Something like that.
I don't know. I like that it's all in the end. I just think they could have had like some very subtle like emotional shit, like, you know, he says a bunch of shit to her instead of her just standing there, and it's just like, you know, you kind of get like the back, or you kind of get like a little look of like fuck that kind of thing, but like still ended up the same way. And do it with more of the characters, you know, because they're trying to like say fuck most of these people's messages. He just wanted to go home and protect his sister. She just wants to fucking go home out of like, you know, the brown chick out of like guild, and because she's like fanatical and shit. And
I'm totally fine too with all of the side characters that you're doing quests for getting totally fucked, because the world's falling apart. That's totally fine to do that.
I think it was almost a little ham-fisted.
I think it was
every single thing ever has to be not happy. Like, come on. Even in some of the worst moments, there's like a touch of okay, you know, to, you know, contrast it. It's like all bleak, or just kind of like, okay, you know, like we get it, man. Especially when it's got such a bubbly art style and shit. Like, the only fucking lighthearted moments are like the comedy grunts.
Mean as pits.
Yeah, that too.
Stinky.
I don't know. I thought the end thing was fine. I think they needed to push the message throughout the whole way. They needed to make you feel like she's like an individual man, and these people are like flexing their wills on her. They needed to make that bigger. The only way you ever really saw that was with her brother, which was fine, but there was way more than her brother going on in the story.
If
the story was just about her brother and her, then that would have been a perfect ending, but it was not. Yeah. And then all that lore and world building, when you have the Raven pop up, like, unless you're pulling a sequel, it feels like a waste, man.
He's not gonna make a sequel.
Yeah. It just feels like kind of a waste of all that world building, because that world building didn't go anywhere, really. I guess. I mean, it set the scene. World building was okay. I just think it was not fully well developed, especially in the beginning where you don't even know what's going on exactly and you're trying to just like piece it together. There's a lot of dialogue for you to have to still piece everything together, man. I don't know. There's just a lot going on. It's not perfect, but I appreciate the concept. Too much mixed shit, man. Do too much shit. Not the worst story I've had in one of these for sure. Overall, I thought it was a good game. Not great, but I think it was pretty good. I think visually, it was good. I think the variety of bosses was good, although I didn't like half the bosses. I think the action wasn't super great. I didn't like a lot of the enemy design. Should have been more variety of stuff you get. I think the side content's bad. I think tweaks are bad. Since everything revolves around tweaks and you don't really need that many tweaks, you don't get any of the side content or don't feel the need, which is also stupid. Music's pretty average. What else am I missing on it? They don't explain what like the engineers are either, the mechanics. So next, we continue Octopath. I don't know if I'll do it right this minute. I don't know if I want to switch gears that hard right now. I never finished Octopath.
Like, mechanic gears.
Yeah, anything else on it, really? And overall, it was above average. Not a whole lot of...
It just had so much potential and shit on it.
Yeah. Like, if I couldn't sit here with a straight face and say it was, like, mediocre. I couldn't say it was bad, for sure. There's just so many little things that I think go wrong. A lot of inconsistent gameplay and
I'm
bosses
never
and
gonna not be mad about the ending.
No,
Like,
I don't.
it doesn't fit.
I think it's fine. I
It's
think
not fit
the
at
very
all.
final bit works. I don't
Yeah,
know about
the
the
her going to
visually.
bed thing
The
works.
bubbly
That's
visually
fine.
thing, maybe.
But
I think they
that
should
it's
have
a good
portrayed it
ending and
differently.
is handled in that fashion does not work, and the bird is bad.
I think the bird's kind of shit, for sure. I think the bubbly portrayal of everything that's going on could maybe be toned down a bit. But how are you going to make it seem like a huge thing happened and the world was changing, everything's all right, and really drive in that final message without making the world actually, like, all right, you know? Like, if she doesn't fully save the world in, like, such a crazy, insane way, like, the whole, I'm going to do what I want, everything's going to turn out good, fuck you message is, like, lessened. So I think it's fine. I just think the portrayal of it's kind of weak, and the bird's kind of like unnecessary. The whole game wasn't that campy, you know. That's fine if the whole game was like that, like I'm playing like a Castle Crashers or some shit, right?
Dude
But
literally has fuzzy dice.
yeah, it was like the game was not on that level of camp, and then all of a sudden it's like super campy. If you're gonna make the game campy and kind of funny like that, then you really needed to tone down the tone of half of the game and cut out half of that fucking serious world building, because it was just like the opposite feel. Oops.
Like, and they don't even hint at anything. They just go, "Oh yeah, it's a Star Worm," and I'm like, "Okay, it's God, cool." And they go, "Oh no, it was aliens." And I'm like, "Okay, but what does that mean? Doesn't mean anything." Which, again, if you're
Maybe there's
going
some
for the
lore
whole message
somewhere.
that the established order does not matter what it is, that fits and that works. But the bird was just like fucking dumb. You don't need to do that.
I think it could have been less subtle if that's what they're pushing. I don't mind that they just hammered that final point in at the end. I think it could have been built up better, like I said, so that it felt more drastic. She just didn't feel like she was anything for most of the game. You just played as her, you know? And no will. When that was the whole point of the end, if she had
I
lots
got
of
into
will.
like a long argument with someone about the ending when I streamed this.
Did you?
And I'll never back down, ever.
What did they say? What was their stance?
Oh, they were defending it and they were saying, "Oh, there was hints to it because like there's feathers on the worm and there's feathers on the bird." And I'm like, dude, stop.
I mean, I'm
Stop.
sure there is like data logs and hints and stuff, but I just don't see why you do it anyways.
Very vague bullshit, just like the rest of the backstory.
I mean, I just don't see the point of doing it anyways. Or put more hints to it. It just doesn't like matter at the end of the day. Like, who cares what the fucking origination of this thing is, I guess. I mean, yeah, that's why their whole religion exists
Yeah,
and shit.
that's the point, is who cares what the origination of the established order is? You're going against it
The
anyway,
point was, is
regardless,
there
because
is
of what
like,
it
yeah,
stands for.
something that
So why would
revolves
you
around it.
bother making an alternate origin of it that's showing up? Why do we care? It doesn't matter. That was the point.
I just think if you didn't have the bird at the end, the entire tone would have been kept intact. And then maybe
Well, except
tone
the deer
down,
thing.
I mean, tone down the portrayal of that part a little bit. You can have the world grow. Maybe you could just make grass grow everywhere. Just like light, you know, like obviously vegetation's coming back, you know, but everywhere. Maybe a couple trees pop up. It was like they were popping up like they were wacky inflatable tube men, and then the fucking dude gets knocked off the edge by the deer. And I get it's supposed to be happy, but I think if you cut the bird, tone down that bit, you keep most of the feel and you can still get the impact of
Also,
her being like,
I
yeah,
think
dude,
the
fuck you.
very last lines with Elro should have been a little different, because he literally says, "I won't tell you what to do anymore." I'm like,
Keep
that's
the
pretty
deer.
awkward. You don't need to say that. You could just like have her physically do something, like hit him, or just have him say sorry or something like that. He just says, "I won't tell you what to do anymore." And I'm like, that's ham-fisting right there.
No, I thought it was fine.
I think that's a weird thing to say.
Well, it's just him finally realizing that she's your own bitch
Yeah,
and
but
that
he
he's been kind of been
literally says,
dumb.
"I won't tell you what to do."
Yeah, but what's wrong with that?
I think it's ham-fisting the message. Like, we get it.
Don't think so. I think ham-fisting it would have been him saying something and then her punching him in the face. It's that it's just really like ignoring him and just going to bed, and he's not giving a fuck.
Maybe. I don't know. I feel like it really could have been done better at the end with Elro. Like the
I think ham fisting would be actually punching ham fisting him with the ham and punching him in the face.
I think the actual words he said were a bad choice.
He's probably just like defeated is what I got the idea. He's not like being nice about it. He's just obviously like realizes he's like just super wrong and he's just fucking like just kinda done. Like he's just a total fucko. Realizes it, I mean with all this shit going on around and then he's just totally in the wrong. I don't know, I thought it was fine. I think her doing anything other than coming back and going to bed would have been bad though. Whether you change the words or not, her going to bed and waking back up, and then going back to bed after he says some shit. Like she's just like, whatever, dude. I think that's good.
I think it is.
Man, because she went against the family and the bird fight.
Just the tone of the ending. Just the whole ending after everything that it built up to. I just felt like it threw it away.
Yeah, I don't feel the tone is the same way you did, I think. I think the tone right before that, yeah, was a little bit
like, the entire game past, like, the first 2 hours was ultra bleak and bad shit was happening everywhere. And then you just end it with, oh, actually, everyone gets happily ever after. You get a nice tree over your home. I'm like, okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Well, it's because I think in the face of all that fucking bullshit, decided to just be like an individual and still like strive for something better, and she got rewarded for it. Because everybody had given up, dude, in the entire story. I think it was a decent mess. Everybody gave up except her, and then she ends up fucking bringing it all back, and then everybody feels like an idiot. I thought that was fine. Like, if it ended up with, wow, the only person who was an individual and actually strove to make things good got fucked, and then nothing ended up great, then, like, they just were right, you know? Which is an even worse fucking message. They had Maria show up. What was her name? Fucking pirate lady. If they had her show up and just like act like, I didn't do anything wrong. Wow, that's really great. You know, then that'd be fucked.
You make the right choices and she does show up for the final boss.
Everybody needs to realize they fucking fucked up. Well, that's fine then. Cause she didn't fucking give up then. You know? What is she? Yeah, what is that whole thing? What are the changes with choices?
That's it. Choices only change the credits and her showing up for the final boss and the shadows of the final boss.
He just shows up and shoots her with you? Shoots him with you?
Yeah.
See, that's fine then. Because it shows she didn't give up on it. I kind of like, where does she show up, like in the middle of the fight?
I don't know. I haven't seen it. I just know it happens.
That'd be kind of shit. I like the message better that your chick goes in alone to get shit done, but you know, through the right choices you still got like a friend or whatever. Nah, we're just gonna do it together. It's the JRPG party going to fight the warlock lord. Yeah. Anywho, that's the end of that game, boys. We're probably critiquing it on a level that maybe it doesn't need to get critiqued on, but that's the whole point of the channel half the time.
It doesn't need to get critiqued.
No.
Try to do something.
No, I'm fine with it. But people are probably like, Jesus, they've been talking about it for an hour.
They can get over it.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck. Get the hell out of here.
It's only been like 25 minutes.
Yeah, no, I'm fine with it. But I don't think we have much to say this point. Right? I'm not bitching.
Wait, you bitch.
I'm bitching. I'm projecting bitching on this invisible 13th person.
Choke.
Alright, choke him.
Choke.
I'm choking on something, bitch.
And pretty much every character was actually good in their own context. Black got too edgy. Mina was pretty fucking shit.
I think some of them got ham-fisted, but otherwise they were fine. I think they needed more backstory and character art.
Absolutely, but what was there was good.
What was there? I don't think it was good. I mean, it was fine, but without those things, I don't think it's good.
I think Chrome on his own merits.
I think Chrome's fine, especially at the end because it comes full circle. I think.